Hello guys, I am Lograj Bhatta from PRBTV. Welcome to our video. This video is about text functions in Microsoft Excel. There are many functions in Microsoft Excel to handle text. There are 8 methods, 8 functions. First one is bar text. It is used to convert a number into a currency of Thailand, which is baht. Here you can see how we can convert a number into that currency. We have to input a number in that function and it will convert it to the corresponding currency. This is not in Roman or Devanagari script. This is entirely different script than ours. If I convert that into English, it will be seem like this. Yes, I have passed 1342 and it converted that into the corresponding bar text. Next method is character. Next function is character function. This function convert a code into character. If we pass a code inside this function will return us the character. That code is a ASCII code. Here I am passing 65 as a argument in character function, then it will return me a capital A, because ASCII character, ASCII value of capital A is 65. Yes, it takes a number or ASCII code as a input and convert that to the corresponding character. We have written about this in our blog also. If you are interested, you can visit this site prv.com. Here you can get computer tricks, tutorials and codes for some programming language also. Next function is clean function. This function removes the non-printable character from the given text. Suppose if we pass any string from clean method, if we pass any string in clean function, then it will remove the non-printable characters. Non-printable character means null is a non-printable character, or backspace, horizontal tab, these are the non-printable characters, or form field. There are about 32 non-printable characters in ASCII table. So if we pass any if there is any non-printable character in our string, then clean method remove these non-printable character and display that as a plain text. For example, here I have concatenated form feed. I think that is form feed whose ASCII character is 16. ASCII value is 16 and 17. One is form feed, another is I don't know exactly. These are concatenated by ampersand sign in between a string. Now I want to pass this entire string in the function. Now you can see the output. The non-printable characters are removed from that string. Okay, that is all about clean method, clean function. Remove all the non-printable characters present in the string. Now, non-printable characters means null, backspace, horizontal tab, okay, vertical tab. These are the non-printable characters. You can see in ASCII table the characters which have values from 0 to 31 are all non-printable. Next function we have is code. Code function work like just opposite to character function. We know character function take a ASCII value and return us a corresponding character, but this takes a character as an input and return us the corresponding ASCII value. For example, we pass capital A, then it returned us 65. look at the second experiment. Yeah, I have passed here 2 A's, but it returns 65 because it convert into corresponding ASCII value to the first letter of string. If you pass a string in this method, this will convert to the first letter. For example, if you pass anything just like PRBTV, then it will convert only P into corresponding ASCII value. It means if you pass a string instead of a character, it will consider only the first character of that string and convert that into the corresponding code. And this works just opposite of character function. As we know, character function take a ASCII code as an input and convert that to the corresponding character. But this function take a character as an input and return us a code that is corresponding to that character. Next function is concatenate function. Actually, this is introduced in 2016 version. It joins multiple text strings into one single string. Means it joins two or more strings. Concatenate function takes two or more strings in it as an argument, then append one string after another. For example, you pass two strings, suppose Beer and Bahadur, then Beer and Bahadur will be concatenated one after another. This is the concatenate function. Suppose I have here 8 values, Rajesh, Manish and so on. I will pass all these values in concatenate function, then it will show output and you can realize how exactly this function is working. It will append all the string one after another, means Rajesh followed by Manish, Manish followed by next. In this way, all are concatenated and converted into a single string. For example, I have converted these two, means John and Bert. There are two strings. Now I passed these both into concatenate function and it is converted into a single string, John Bert. This is not complex, this is simple. Okay, this is about concatenate function. We have another function, that is dollar. This function convert our currency format, convert your number to currency format. Means we have to pass a number into this function and it will convert that number into corresponding currency format. That format may be USD or rupees, Indian rupees, that may be anything according to your setting in Excel. For example, if you pass a number, then it will convert that into the currency format, means it will be with proper comma separation and sign of the currency, means that may be dollar or rupees. In this function, there may be a second argument, that is an integer number, which represent the number of digits after decimal point, means it represent the precision of that number. Next function we have is exact function. This function compares two strings and return the boolean value that may be either true or false, and this comparison is case sensitive. It will check whether all the characters in both string are same, means same and are in same order and are in same case, uppercase or lowercase. In this way, this compare two strings and returns true if these both strings are exactly same, otherwise it will return false. Yes, in this example I have passed two strings in this method. Okay, I'm gonna write here my brother's name, John Bhatt, in both cells. Now I want to pass these both strings into our function, first and second. Now it must be true. Okay, it is shown false. I think there is a space, extra space between in the zone end part in second string. I will remove that and it will be true. Okay, that's true, fine. And we have next function find. Find function return the position of search string, means it return an integer number that is the index of a search string in another string, means it will take at least two string. One is the string to be find, another is a string in which we have to find, means first string will be searched in second string, and it will return the index of second string where it find the first string. Okay, it will be more clear after this example. We can say first string as a search string. Then after we have to find the search string in the second argument string, and that function will return the index at which that string is, that search string is found in the second argument. Here is the optional third argument also in this function, that is a number which represent the index in second argument from which we have to start looking for search string. For example, if we pass 5, then the searching of search string, means process of finding of search string, will be started from 5th index of second argument string. For example, here is a string, a long string, and there is first argument as a search, and second is the longer string, and third is the 1 or 2, and it is returning the index where it find the sub string. That is about the find function. Important thing is that it return the integer, it takes two string, and optionally an integer at last. Among these two string, first one is the search string, means the string which is to be searched or which we have to find, means what we have to find, that is the first argument. And second argument string is where we have to find, means where we have to search for the first string. Thank you for watching. Please like our video and subscribe our channel to motivate us for creating such kind of videos. Thank you.